How's it going, folks? Peter here, and I'll tell you something. I am super excited today because guess what we've got in front of us? We've got the Lima Railways 1987-1988 British edition 00 scale or 00 gauge model train catalogue. And I'll tell you something, folks. It's got a drawing of my favourite Class 43 HST on the front. And I got that one as a train set back in 1986. And I'm sure many of you that are watching my videos have already seen that one. But if not, please do check the playlist of my model train reviews, as I do N-scale, N-gauge, whichever the part of the world you are from, as well as HO scale and 00 gauge model trains respectively. But just check this out, folks. I am super excited and I'm just rubbing my hands with glee right here. Let's get into it then. Let's get this cover open. 1987, 1988. Okay, before we go too far off on a tangent, let's just do some adjustments on the fly here, okay? So make sure we've got that all on view. As you know, these older catalogues, they do spread quite far, and I really do love doing these ones. And I thought I'd do this one as the second catalogue exploration retro model trains video. So here we go, folks. Boundless possibilities for railways modelling. And I'll tell you something, I do not disagree with that one bit. Just look at that, folks. The Lima Golden Series there. Brand new for 1987. And check this out, folks. This is the revised Intercity Executive livery. As you know, folks, this was the livery I was talking about. I do want to cover one of these in a future review. So I'm going to hunt one of these down and do the train pack. I love that livery. That is my favourite of the Intercity liveries that British Rail had back in the 1980s. And I can just barely contain my excitement when it comes to this kind of stuff. Sorry. And I don't apologise for that either. I am what I am, and that's just the way I am, folks. And here we go. We did the train set version of that to close 2023 down, and this one is the train pack version, and it will have headlights and stuff. So I have yet to cover a Lima HST with the headlights and stuff, so I don't know what it's like, as the three train sets of the Lima Class 43 HSTs that I have done in the past, they don't have lights, folks, so I don't know what to expect or if they are any good for that matter. So I don't think it'll be any different to Hornby. And we got this Trans-Europe Express high-speed train. I think that could be Dutch or Swiss. I'm not sure. I think it's Dutch, that one. Comes from the Netherlands, that cream and red one. This one is a French TGV. It's a TGV Paris Sud-Est, of which is the original TGV, the Mark 1, as I tend to call it. And we do have our rail cars here, folks. So these are before 1987, so nothing new there. And we do have various locomotives, steam engines, all that good stuff. In fact, I'm sure most of you will know them all. I'm not that up on steam trains, but I just learn about the ones I like, you know. I'm neutral towards steam trains. I don't dislike them or overly like them. I'm just in the middle. I'm just neutral. I just have mutual respect for them, for the fact that they were the godfathers of trains to how the railways have evolved to today. As I've said that previously, and check this out, folks. The large logo rail freight for 1987 Various liveries for the Class 08 diesel shunters on the left there, folks. And, of course, the Class 20s. Okay, new Class 37s, I see. Very nice stuff. Large logo blue, BR green, BR blue, rail freight. All that good stuff. Class 33. I believe they were called Cromptons or something. And they are built by Brush, as far as I know. I really need to get one of these to do a review of it. And sadly, I never got round to reviewing that one that was broken that I got last year. And I just let that one go for spares or repairs. But it is on the cards, folks. And I do plan to do a Lima Class 33. And I may do a review of a Hellion one in the future as well. So there we go, folks. Brand new for 1987 here. Class 47 diesel locomotive. And we've got the Class 42 warships as well. So lots of exciting brand new models for 1987, 1988 here, folks. So we've got the Class 52s and some Class 50s. We've got some new Network Southeast stuff. So as you can tell, back in the late 1980s, that was a grand time to get into the hobby. And I'm sure most of you will agree with me on that, you know. Wow, just look at this. I love that executive livery, that Intercity executive livery with the large logos. Does that not look cool? These two here. I'm sure most of you will agree with me. And we got the Class 55 Deltics as well. Although, I do believe they were released in the early 1980s, so it wasn't new back then. Same with these Class 117 diesel rail cars. And I would like to do a review of this one, as well as the blue and grey version. I do have the refurbished one that I did do last year, but I would like to do that one. And speaking of which, check this out. So we've got the three separate cars. The refurbished BR Class 117. And we've got the HSTs here, folks. The original Intercity Executive. Phase 1 Intercity Executive livery. As well as the BR Blue and Grey. Got the Phase 2 Intercity Executive livery. So I'll call that the Phase 2. And moving over here, folks. Sadly, no Intercity Swallow livery, as that came out in 1988 by Lima, I do believe. And we do have some GWR rail cars, including a BR green version. Anyway, just having some fun here, folks, and I really am. We've got Class 87s, BR blue, Intercity, all that good stuff. Passenger carriages. To get those 00 gauge commuters from A to B in style and in safety like. Okay. Nice liveries. This is the 1963 BR Mark 1s and all that. And we've got various collars and all that good stuff. And we're on to the BR blue and grey livery issued here as well. Now check this out. You see this electric multipole unit there, that one there, just going past the signal. That's a Class 310 or a Class 310, excuse me. Now, as far as I know, nobody, even to this present day, has produced a Class 310. And they were on the West Coast Main Line, and they used to run from London, Euston, to as far as Birmingham New Street, and I think even further than that, as I'm sure some of them did go as far as Liverpool back in the days of British Rail. And the Class 310s were replaced in the late 1980s, by the Class 321s. So, interesting. Lima does a photograph with a Class 310 coming out of, I think it's London Euston, folks. So I think that's London Euston. And yet, ironically, they never ever produced a 00 gauge model of a Class 310. So, interesting. And yet, here we are. Plenty of BR blue and grey Mark 1 coaches. And then we move on to the Mark 2s. So we've got newcomers for 1987, so that's grand. And we've got the Mark 3s in the intercity blue and grey livery. These being based on the Loco Holden HST versions. Although, funny enough, all of the coaches had buffers, irrespective if they were designed for HST use or locomotive hold. It was just a genetic buffered Mark 3 coach. And if you were modelling a HST using the Lima carriages and you wanted them to look realistic, you would have to hacksaw the buffers off to remove the buffers, as sadly they were moulded into the tooling and they were not detachable, unlike the Hornby counterparts. But anyways, Intercity executive here, folks, on the Mark 1 coaches and the Mark 2s and Mark 3s. So, plenty to choose from. And these are not new, the Mark 3s. They're from 1986. Same year I got my train set. Okay, Intercity Pullman. They'd be used with a Class 87. They would be used with a Class 87. And they would run from Manchester to possibly London Euston. I believe they were used for Class 86, Class 87s out of Manchester, right down to London Euston. And we do have some ScotRail versions here, folks. So you'd run these with a Class 47 and a cab car at the other end, but you'd have to scratch build that back in the 1980s if you wanted the realistic train. Well, folks, we've got some Network Southeast stuff and various Mark 1 and Mark 2 carriages, and that's the carriages done. We're now on to the freight cars. Various types, various liveries, all that good stuff. And I don't think we're even halfway through this brochure. Actually, I think we've just passed the halfway mark on this brochure, as there's quite a lot to cover in this one. But if you want to pause it, have a look at them, or go cycle back through the video and stuff for references, please do, you know. And I just enjoy doing these exploration videos, you know. Various granite hoppers, iron ore wagons and all that good stuff. Tank cars, parcel cars, for all your packages and stuff. It's all grand. And we've got some specialist carrier wagons for things like fertilizers and stuff for the farming industry and all that, you know. And we've got car transporters, permanent way, recovery crane. And here we go, folks. Trap packs and all that good stuff. Okay, just moving on, making sure we've covered everything. Accessories, and I'll tell you something. I can tell you what this truck is based on. It is based on the 1978 Iveco or Iveco Turbostar. That's what these trucks are based on, the truck cabs and stuff. I'm 99% certain that is based on the Iveco or Iveco Turbostar truck cab with various trailers and stuff. As you know, you've got the box trailers there, the low loader, all that good stuff. And would that not look cool with a Class 08 on the back of it? Obviously, not realistic, but this is 1987, 1988 there, folks, you know. But, so, gosh, getting tongue-tied. So, it is what it is. And I'm not editing the video. I just like to cover these retro stuff. And I am in my element here, folks. So we've got the carriage wash, railroad crossings, a swing bridge, and all that good stuff. HO style station. So that'd be based on something in France. Not really suitable for the UK, but it does the job. And it's better than nothing. And we've got several road vehicles, bridges, all that good stuff. Working signals. So more of the Iveco or Iveco Turbostar trucks, Shell, Seaboard Express, I believe that's what it means. And we've got Dunlop and another operator there as well. And several containers of various operators and that. Excellent stuff, you know. Signals, more suitable for Europe than the UK, but this is 1987, 1988. It's all about having fun and using your imagination. That's what model trains were all about, you know. Working catenary system, so all grand. And track packs, layout designs, power controllers, spare parts, and it's all here, folks. Everything you could ever need to start an epic model railway. And there is even guides on how to build a model railway. And this is 1987, 1988 here, folks. Now, just look how cool that looks. I'll tell you something. I might even consider, although I will use newer track, I might even attempt to have a go at building one of these. Just for a selection of videos and stuff, you know. Because I love creativity. I really do. I absolutely love being creative. And to be honest, I like doing good deeds as well. But there we go, folks. And that concludes our lovely exploration video of this 1987-1988 Lima Railways. 1987-1988 British edition 00 scale Lima models model train catalogue exploration. As always, folks, take care of yourselves, take care of each other. All the best, God bless, take care, and I will see yous in the next one. And as always, folks, if you're new to the channel and you do enjoy my content, feel free to subscribe to stay in touch with my regular uploads. And if you find this video useful, please hit that like button. It really does help. Meanwhile, thank you, take care, and I'll see you in the next one.